The maritime security expert sees no reason for China to send its biggest Coast Guard ship to Panatag Shoal other than to intimidate. Speaking to ANC, Ray Powell, director of the Sea Light Gordian Knot Center for National Security Innovation of Stanford University, said China's trying to intimidate and coerce the Philippines to bend to its will.
It is clearly intended to send a message. There's no real reason. So, for example, just to begin with, this ship is of unreasonably large size for a Coast Guard ship. There's really not any sort of reason to have a Coast Guard ship, which is supposed to, you know, provide maritime safety and, you know, secure borders. So the entire point of this ship is to intimidate and to coerce. And that's what it does when it's in other countries' EEZs. It's frequently in Vietnam's, it's also in Malaysia's. Sometimes it will visit Indonesia's. So this is why this ship exists, is to send messages.
Powell also expressed alarm over China's new Coast Guard rule to arrest what Beijing considers as trespassers. He explains this could be used by China to extract concessions from Manila.
This is what really concerns me, to a hostage diplomacy situation, mm-hmm. where all of a sudden you see a, you know, Philippine citizen being kept in a jail cell in Hainan Island, for example, and now China is going to use that circumstance as a way to try to extract concessions while claiming that it's not holding the person hostage, but simply detaining someone who violated its borders. But the clear intent is to put the Philippines over a barrel.
A senior official of the Land Transportation Office shot dead in Quezon City on Friday. The victim was identified as Mercedita Gutierrez, chief of the registration section of the LTO Central Office. According to one witness, the victim's van was cut off by the gunman on board a motorcycle. Then two shots can be heard. The LTO has condemned the brazen attack. LTO Chief Assistant Secretary Vigor Mendoza says they are closely working with authorities to bring the perpetrators to justice. The Quezon City Police District has formed a task force to investigate the killing. The Philippine Congress urged to pass the amended rice tariffication law, which would allow the National Food Authority to import rice. This appeal made by President Marcos Jr., saying it will help stabilize rice prices. Government is also pursuing other measures to boost rice production, including using weatherproof rice varieties. On top of this, farmers would also receive much-needed assistance in the form of fertilizers and machinery. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department vows to provide full assistance to the five Filipinos injured in the turbulence-hit Singapore Airlines flight. They are currently receiving medical care in Bangkok, Thailand, including two who suffered neck injuries. The Singapore Airlines flight was headed for Singapore from London on Tuesday when it encountered severe turbulence, forcing it to make an emergency landing in Thailand. The incident led to injuries of over 100 people on board and the death of a 70-year-old man. Now, Singapore Airlines has vowed to shoulder all hospital expenses of the affected passengers until their full recovery. The Philippine government moving to address the growing number of Filipino health workers choosing to work abroad. Easy Lee reports.
Many medical students are determined to work in the United States or the United Kingdom. They say the plan of the Philippine Health Department to provide more benefits to healthcare workers is not enough to convince them to stay.
Gusto ko rin mag-migrate sa ibang bansa. I think I'm going to take the boards sa other country kasi ano, in terms of benefits and also the salaries sa ibang bansa, also the healthcare system sa ibang bansa, mas better plan ng government na to implement those plans. Pero yung sa ibang other countries, implemented na siya. Sa bansa natin, I doubt na ma-implement na maayos yan, like, na consistently.
This medical technologist shares the same opinion. He plans to work abroad because his salary has remained stagnant despite his more than a decade-long experience.
If ever po na may maipangako man ganun, na sana tuloy-tuloy po yung maging pagbigay, maging consistent po.
Minsan ba napapaisip ka na gusto mo rin mag-abroad? O dati ganun talaga naging pangarap?
Hindi na po ako magsisinungaling, napapaisip po talaga. Like, winiway ko na po yung options. Although gusto ko magstay dito, pero kung para po kasi sa parang current na pangangailangan po. Hindi na po talaga sumasapat eh.
Among the benefits the health department is looking to implement are scholarships, housing, and improved pay. However, all this are still under study and depend heavily on budget availability.
Papasok tayo sa budget season ngayon, no? So kasama yan sa mga proposals na aming inihahaing for discussion. Fingers crossed, kung mabilis at magandang abukasiya at may pera na available, we can get it as early as next year, but we cannot make commitments.
Assistant Secretary Albert Domingo says from 1992 to 2019, an average of around 10,000 nurses and 350 doctors leave the country annually. He says government is also working on putting up more medical facilities which could offer a more competitive pay for health workers.
Gumagawa po ng mga ospital, hindi lang ospital, pati ng mga clinic, mga bagong urgent care and ambulatory service centers nationwide kung saan kailangan natin ng doctors and more importantly nurses and midwives. Kasi kung mas marami yung supply ng pwedeng pagtrabahuhan sa labor market, yung demand na marami masasatisfy at hindi sila malulugi pagdating sa usaping sweldo.
According to Domingo, to meet sustainable development goals such as reducing tuberculosis, maternal deaths, and HIV/AIDS cases, the Philippines needs around 512,000 healthcare workers. With approximately 302,000 practitioners currently inactive, there is a gap of 195,116 healthcare workers in the Philippines.
Ito ay isang estimation. Hindi siya yung tipong nakadistribute in the regions. But in other words, kung sa buong bansa ay gusto natin magkaroon tayo ng magandang health outcomes for the SDGs, dapat mapunuan natin yung ganong number na yun.
The DOH is also evaluating a proposal to hire nurses who did not pass the nursing board exams. Easily, ABS-CBN News.
Buckle up, motorists. Prices at the pumps are seen heading higher, potentially breaking a four-week streak of price rollbacks. Estimates show fuel prices could go up by at least 20 centavos to as much as 40 centavos per liter next week. A Filipino janitor turned baker brings flavors of the Philippines to Chicago. Connie Matula De Leon tells us more about the man behind Umaga Bakehouse.
When Robert Fagaragan moved to the U.S. from the Philippines at the age of 16, he spoke very little English and barely made ends meet as a janitor at a bakery in California. But he persevered.
Keep working and keep learning everything.
He worked his way up from cleaning the floors to becoming a baker, a job he was familiar with since his family owned a small bakery in Ilocos Norte. Fagaragan met his wife, Giselle, at the same bakery they were employed at. Fast forward to 2024, the Filipino couple saw an opportunity to open their own bakery in Chicago, called it Umaga, and began offering Filipino baked goods, dishes, and desserts. Their goal? To bring a taste of home to Chicago Pinoys.
We picked Umaga because, you know, when you think of a bakery, you want to come in the morning with the hot, fresh bread. It was just more of like a refreshing start of the day. And also not just the morning, but just like the whole day.
Being in the food industry is also not new to Giselle, since her family used to own a bakery in California. But she says having her own also means stepping up her game.
We've been trying to keep our best, like just trying to keep up with the demand. And at the end of the day, we wanted to keep the customers coming and happy. So all this has been like an overwhelming experience, but it's a good problem to have.
Their location is strategic. It is close to Seafood City and other Filipino stores.
This is pretty much a Filipino hub. This is a Filipino-centric area, so it's perfect, and it's also right off the highway. So convenience of just like going to work or coming from work, we're right there.
Filipinos here say it reminds them of bakeries they grew up with in the Philippines.
It attracted a lot of attention from not just Filipinos, but people from other countries as well. I think it's also a great way to share more of like the Filipino culture that maybe other people wouldn't necessarily think of, like pastries.
These customers have their favorites.
Panisal. Panisal.
Ginataan.
Yung shupo.
Tsaka yung ano yung... Ano ba yung may asukal?
Insamada.
Robert shares these pieces of advice to fellow Filipinos looking to also find success in America.
Be humble lang. Be humble. trabaho, magsipag, at darating din yung oportunidad para sa inyo. Just keep working and then hard work pays off.
Connie Macatula de Leon, ABS-CBN News, Chicago.